Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station whereby we are going to interact and learn together. Today we are going to have a biology form 3, lesson 18, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Gerald. We are going to handle the topic on ecology and the subtopic, the adaptations of plants to various habitats. We are going to have the following lesson goal, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to identify the adaptations of their, of xerophytes to their habitat. Let us begin so that we may get these adaptations. For that, we can introduce something on the adaptations of various of plants to various habitats, whereby an adaptation is a change in an organism that increases its chances of survival in a specific environment. These changes may be structural, behavioral, or physiological, as you are aware. Plants possess different adaptations based on their habitats. Hence, there are four main groups of plants. Namely, one, we have the xerophytes, we have the mesophytes, we have the hydrophytes, and we have the allophytes. Now, we are going to start with the first group of plants, which are the xerophytes. And the xerophytes are plants adapted to withstand a dry habitat or to endure conditions of prolonged drought, as in arid and semi-arid areas. These habitats are characterized by the following conditions. They have unpredictable and poorly distributed rainfall, which is usually less than around 250 to 350 millimeters per year. Very high day temperatures, but very low night temperatures. The areas where the xerophytes are found, we are saying that they have very high day temperatures and very low night temperatures, which results in high diurnal temperature range. The habitats also, they are very windy and they have low humidity. So because of those reasons, the xerophytes have developed mechanisms of surviving, whereby the adaptations include: one, the leaves are reduced in size, such as the scale-like leaves of whistling pine. Can have a diagrammatic representation of the same. So as I am trying to give the adaptations, you'll be studying these adaptations on our diagrams on our screen. The second adaptation is that shedding of leaves during drought to reduce the surface exposed to transpiration. The leaves have thick wax cuticle to minimize the rate of cuticular transpiration, as you can see. Some leaves are folded to reduce the rate of transpiration by not exposing stomata to environmental factors. Our fifth adaptation of this xerophyte is that some have sunken stomata, which accumulate moisture in substomatal air spaces, leading to low diffusion gradient, thus reducing transpiration rate. Our next adaptation is that most xerophytes show reduced number of stomata that lowers the rate of transpiration. Our seventh adaptation is that some xerophytes experience a reverse stomatal rhythm, that is opening the stomata at night and closing them by day to prevent excessive loss of water by transpiration. Our eighth adaptation is that some plants have deep roots to absorb water from deep in the soil. For example, we have the acacia tree. Other plants have superficial roots which grow horizontally close to the soil surface to absorb water after a short or light shower of rain. Another adaptation is that some plants store water in large parenchyma cells, which are contained in the succulent stem and leaves. Our last but not the least adaptation is that some xerophytes have a very short life cycle to evade drought, and some survive as seeds or as underground penetrating organs. We are through with the xerophytes. Now we can look at the hydrophytes, whereby a plant living under normal conditions of water supply or in well-watered soils is described as a mesophyte. Mesophytes are predominantly found in such ecosystems as the savanna, the rainforest, and the reserve forest. The habitats of mesophytes have the following general characteristics. One, there is adequate rainfall ranging from around 950 millimeters to 1800 millimeters that is distributed through the year. Yes. Our second characteristic is that humidity is relatively high. Our third characteristic is that thick clouds are also common. Another characteristic is that moderate to high temperatures with low diurnal range. Another characteristic is that they are less windy and shallow water table. Now we can look at the adaptations of the mesophytes to their habitats, whereby the first adaptation is that Most have broad leaves. These broad leaves, they are able to lose water to the environment because they are situated in places where there is a lot of water. Our second adaptation is that they have parenchyma tissues, whereby these parenchyma tissues they can be used even for breathing. They have poorly developed root system. The poor developed system is because they don't have to be deep rooted, because the water is found on shallowly, so they can absorb water just not deep in the soil. Their flowers are raised above water to allow pollination. Remember, we have said that these anthophytes are found in places where there is a lot of water. So their flowers are actually raised above the water to allow pollination. We have our fifth characteristic, whereby their leaves have broad surfaces. This is to allow extensive transpiration, either through the cuticles, the stomata, or any other transpiration method. They possess shallow roots. This is because actually they are found in water, so they don't have to be deep rooted, so that at least they grow. These are the examples of the anthophytes. Now these are the examples of the anthropophytes. Having done and said that, we are going to have the following activity, whereby I should identify the adaptations of the anthropophytes to their habitat. For more of this lesson, you can refer to KLB, Secondary Biology Experience Book 3, which is the 4th edition, Nairobi, Kenya Literature Bureau. And to get this lesson and many more of our biology lessons, you can send us an SMS through this number that is on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you can subscribe to our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you tweet us at @ElimuTV_Kenya. Let us subscribe to all these channels so that we might enjoy this and many more of our biology lessons. Thank you.